Hello, hello. We're live, we're live. Hot mic, hot mic. Hi, everybody. Thank you so much. This is an incredible audience. Yeah,
you guys were absolutely phenomenal. I know it was redundant, but seriously.
I am Blake Price. This is Ashton Corey. You can, he's chewing something right now. And this is James Taylor Odom, and I play Monty,
Dice Prince,
Man One. So I was the guard and the bust and about 12 other different characters.
Everyone's changing hats. So if you have any questions, we are here to answer them, truly. Yes. Oh, go ahead.
My question has to do with your schedule. First of all, where are you going to be tomorrow?
We're flying to Atlanta. This guy's hometown.
Atlanta. How many shows do you do a week, and how does the stage get where you are?
Oh, that's a great question. So it changes from venue to venue. So tonight we're only here for one night, unfortunately. We love San Antonio, so this is a tough one to say goodbye to, especially because the audience numbers were incredible. But in Atlanta, we'll do about eight shows, I'd say. Yep, eight shows. Your typical eight-show schedule, two on Saturday and Sunday, but every other day, one show a night, not including Monday. And it just sprinkles. We don't really have any more than eight at a time. But there are some days when we're, or some weeks when we're doing four, because we're traveling from stop to stop. So it can vary. Sometimes it's harder on the body than others, but it's a blast. I mean, either way, it's one of those things where it just keeps you moving, keeps things changing. And as far as the stage, we have an incredible crew who you can hear are kind of prepping to tear it down. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, you get to watch that in action, don't
you? A little bit. So that travels with us on buses. How many buses? Two trucks. Four trucks carry the stage. Two buses carry all of us. So yeah, it's actually, compared to some other tours, it's actually a smaller amount.
So how long have you been running the show so far, and how long will you run it?
October 3rd, we open in Madison, Wisconsin, and then we close May 13th in Butte, Montana. Including rehearsal. Yes, yeah.
Austin will be in Austin for a week.
So if your friends weren't able to see the show tonight, it's
eight shows.
It's a quick Texas drive to Austin. I know Texas drives are very different from everywhere else. I've worked with. Yes.
So for a show like this, where there's a lot of comedic timing, do you guys ever find it difficult when you're doing so many shows to like continue to hit those timings? Because I've done comedy shows before, and sometimes when you do them multiple times, it gets really tough.
Yeah, finding the inspiration to trust the work that we've done it will be funny. Can be challenging, especially when you go to some venues that are more responsive than others, and so there's a tendency to want to push, or there's a tendency to want to add so much stuff. I think, the beauty of this is truly allowing yourself to live within the parameters of what we've set, and there lies the fun, I think. But certainly, it is a challenge, absolutely, to hit those marks. But, once you do it as many times as you do, it becomes second nature in some ways. It's choreography, really.
We don't have any fun
together. Obviously, he and I don't get along. It's very much one of those things, We just do it out of spite, really. It really is. I mean, he and I have built a relationship with one another on stage where it's at any point we get to try new things. As long as we're staying in the context of the show, keeping things tight, keeping the story and the movement and the show moving along, we always love to have fun. Absolutely. Yes, sir?
Hi. This one's for Mr. Odom. What's it like playing so many characters on stage?
It's insane. No, it's a joy. It really is exhilarating to be able to do this. It's a dream come true for an actor. You know, I feel greedy, I really do, considering, you know, I'm taking all these roles away from other people. even though these guys, like Ashton and the rest of the crew, are playing multiple characters in these ensemble numbers that are doing just as much work back behind me, it's a blast to dive into these different characters, seeing how different they are, yet how similar, because they're all related, and finding how to make them distinct. Through voice, through stature, and obviously the beautiful Tony-nominated and award-winning costumes that we have are gorgeous. So those also, yeah, they help define those characters in the rehearsal room as well, and that is a joy for me. As soon as I put them on, they just, you know, the character kind of comes to life. And that's just technical. Then you look at the script, and there's all the beautiful work there, that everything is pretty straightforward.
Also a Tony in the book. We won the Tony.
Absolutely.
Robert Freeman won the Tony for the book. It's pretty good.
I have two quick questions. The first one for Mr. Odom. What was your fastest quick change?
14 seconds. Sometimes that kind of can play between 14 and 16, but I think that would be, I have a hard time remembering this. I think it's going from I don't understand the poor into the tower scene. And basically that as soon as the curtain's coming down with the final button, then I'm ripping off my mustache hat, ripping off my clothes, I'm diving into the priest costume, putting on false teeth, putting on the wig, getting some water, and starting my, shakes as the old priest. So
sometimes that water is still in his mouth while you start the scene. And so he'll say this line and be spitting in my face, which is sometimes what you see is me acting, sometimes it's me actually reacting to him spitting in my face. It's a fun thing we do.
The second question can go for any of you. What continues to drive you to perform?
Go for it, Ashton.
Oh, I guess I'm talking.
I feel like for the two of us, like, we get to play incredibly meaty roles that, like, when I saw this on the Tonys, I was like, I have to do this. I have to. And every night we get to play, we get to have a blast up here where our ensemble doesn't necessarily get the kind of, I guess, glory that we might get because we're, two of the main dudes. But at the end of the day, we can't do our show without this guy, without our crew, without his dressers, without people handing me props out of that tiny little cubby right there at exactly the right moment. I mean, it's incredibly a team effort. So Ashton, tell us how you do it.
Well, at least for me, I'm driven by the fact that, one, I just love this show. I saw it 4 times and it was on Broadway. It's so much fun and it never gets old. It's fun every time. And I think there's the joy in touring and bringing this to people and knowing every night someone out there, lots of people out there, haven't seen this show. And also, when it comes to touring, we have lovely local crew members in every theater we play, so we get to meet new people backstage. So even though it's the same show, we're always in a different city, performing for different people, with a different crew, and it's always just fun. It's fun. I think that's what drives me the most, knowing that I'm bringing this show to New Year's every night.
I think my code was at the time, so in my bio, she's referring to my bio, where if you open the program, I mention near the end of it that my dad basically berated me for like 2 hours because I gave my friend that he didn't know at the time the garage code to get into our house. That was a rough one. But I was apologizing to him for that. They saw it in Toledo in November. But I believe it was, and no longer is, 2424. I mean, it was a really bad code, really. It's on them.
When you arrive at a venue, do you actually have to have a rehearsal so the crew knows what's going on?
It depends. There's some, like, for example, what we do is sound check. And what you saw for the door number, the Decide to Marry You number, the one that, if anyone knows this show, that's usually the thing that they remember the most. We always rehearse that, and it lets Jack, our incredible audio, incredible head of sound, he, But it gives him a chance to show us the levels, kind of hear what the space is doing, and it lets us hear how the orchestra sounds, how the space sounds, because every venue is different. This is a beautiful space where we don't always get this kind of quality of space. Sometimes it's bigger, sometimes it's smaller, and it takes a quick rehearsal to adjust that, at least sound-wise. Sometimes we're adjusting blocking, it can vary. But we don't have to have a rehearsal every time. No.
So what is the most challenging part of being a touring group?
For me, the most challenging part of touring, I think, is eating well is one. Sometimes we're in hotels that are near nothing, so we have to plan ahead and look on our schedule, see where we're going to be. Stock up on groceries on the bus if we need to, order food to the theater sometimes, because we're crunched for time. I think that's one of the hardest things, is eating well, keeping active and working out, because we get done with these shows, and it's really easy to just be tired, and so I think keeping up, personal health, but we do it, it's a different challenge, and I think as a performer, one of the more shocking, challenging things is the difference from city to city in elevation and humidity. Our immune systems are probably stronger than they've ever been because doing a lot of public flights and changing. I know when we were in, where were we? Albuquerque? No, Colorado Springs. High elevation, we're all back there.
I had to have an oxygen tank for me backstage. Yeah. It was just terrible,
Leave the stage, so I don't get any of that. I actually wasn't too bad because I worked in Utah. I worked in Utah at 5,800 feet, so I was like, I at least was accustomed to being really high. But yeah, that's probably the best way to put it. I mean, it's the kind of the inconsistency of things that you're surrounded by to eat, and just the schedule itself can take a toll. Really, going from place to place, and every place is different. But that's also kind of why we love it, It's always different.
Right. We really loved having you here. And we know that you have to move on from here, so we'll let you go work out or go to sleep if you need.
Oh, I'm not working out.
But we do hope that you at least got breakfast taco or two or some of the food here.
Oh, yeah. Food's incredible. Love the room.
Well, thank you so very much. Thank you, folks, for hanging out. I hope you enjoy the next initiative of Generation 2.